It's all right, Molly. Annie's here.
It was my mama, Annie. We was riding on a ferry boat and she was holding me up to see all the big ships. And then I couldn't find her no more.
Blow, it was only a dream, honey. Now you gotta go back to bed. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, read me your notes.
Again?
Please?
Sure, Mom.
Here it comes again.
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We will be back to get her soon.
We have left half a silver locket around her neck and kept the other half. So that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, now they're laughing.
All right, you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I dream of having a mother and father again. But you're lucky, you really got them.
I know, somewhere.
Maybe far away, or maybe real nearby. He may be pouring her coffee, she may be straightening his tie. Maybe in a house, all hidden by a hill. Sitting playing piano, he's sitting paying a bill.
Betcha they're young, betcha they're smart.
But they come like they
like asteroids and dart.
Betcha they're
what shouldn't they be?
Their one mistake was giving up me. So maybe now it's time, and maybe when I wake, they'll be there calling me baby, maybe.
Good luck, Annie.
So long, Dumbbell, and good luck.
I said turn around! There, now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Rotten orphan.
I am not an orphan! My mother and father left a note saying that they loved me, that they were coming back for me.
That was 1922. This is 1933. Get up! Now, for this one's shenanigans, you'll all get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building!
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Get to work!
Yes, Miss Hannigan!
Now! Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
Annie! neck she got away. But we're gonna have to pay. Gonna get our faces slapped.
Gonna get our knuckles wrapped. It's a hard knock life. It's a hard knock life.
Have you seen any stray mutts around here?
No, sir.
Good, then you must all be running well over to the Astor place.
Hey! There's one they didn't get! They're after you, ain't they? They're after me, too. But don't worry. I won't let them get you or me. Everything's gonna be fine. For the both of us. If not today, well...
The sun'll come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh. The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may,
here.
Yes, officer?
That dog there. Ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer. He's my dog.
Your dog, huh? So, what's his name?
His name? His name is Sandy. That's right. I call him Sandy because of his beautiful sandy color.
Okay, let's see him answer
but
to his
you
name.
See, sir, I just got him and sometimes...
Call him.
Here, Sandy. Here, boy. Here, Sandy! Come on, you can do this! Sandy, no, no! You're my dog! Sandy! Sandy! Come here! Oh, good boy! That's a good boy! Good boy! Good Sandy!
Next time you check him out, he better have a license.
Yes, sir, I understand.
Now, get along, all right?
Yes. When I'm stuck with a chain that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh. The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may,
Can you pull it from Coney Island?
Yeah.
Molly just threw up on it.
A mangy mutt with her, but he got away.
Oh, my poor pumpkin out in the freezing cold with nothing but that thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thanks so much again, officer.
All in the language. And you, don't let me ever hear that you run away again from this nice lady. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, officer. The next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back? Huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Right! What's the one thing I always stop? Never tell a lie!
Good afternoon. Miss Hannigan?
Yes?
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? The millionaire?
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
And what sort of an orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSISSIPPI, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
Oh, you!
You shut up!
And how old?
Oh, well, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9? 10? 11? Yes, 11 will be perfect.
Yeah, sorry, we don't have any orphans like that.
What about this child right here?
Annie? Oh, no, you don't want her.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
Oh, I would love to.
You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Perhaps I should call the Board of Orphans and see how
if it's any you want, it's any you get.
It's any I want.
Oh, boy!
If you'll get your coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy!
Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is outside.
Oh, boy! I can hardly believe it!
She can hardly believe it?
Hey, kids! I'm getting out of here for Christmas. I'll write to you.
Someday I'll land in a nut house with all the nuts and the squirrels. There I'll stay tucked away till the prohibition of
thank you. afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake. Everyone.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Has Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, we're expecting him any minute now.
Do you really live here, or is this a train station?
We really live here. Now, would you all gather around for a moment, please?
Quickly, everyone.
This is Annie. She'll be with us for Christmas. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Well, of course, dear. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first, then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning. You're a guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now,
Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Green is the best color, so blue, I think.
Your bath is drawn by Mrs. Green.
So, no bubbles, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
So, no, this time she's in there.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
When you wait, bring four trays, Drake will bring your tray. When you're through, Mrs. Pew comes to take it away. No need to pick up any straw.
That's okay, I haven't got it anyway.
No figure will you win.
And have ice cream sold out at Rumpelmere's and a handsome cab ride around Central Park. Grace, forget about the dictations. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Ah, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
Well, it's just that I thought you were going to take me.
Oh, no. I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight.
Ah, gee.
Now, Annie, I've just been away 6 weeks, and when a man is running a multi-billion dollar corporation...
Oh, sure.
I understand, Mr. Warbucks. I know.
Drink!
Yes, sir.
Get our coats.
Ah, gee!
And Grace, welcome to you, of course.
Yes, sir.
Which car will you be taking, sir?
Ah, the Duesenberg. No, wait! This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell those bus fumes. There's nowhere like the air of New York. Come on, you slowpokes. You've got to get to the Roxy before the prices change.
Square, but wow, I come alive.
The city's bright as a penny arcade. It blinks, it tips, it rings.
To think that I've lived here all my life and never seen these things.
NYC, the whole world is coming by bus, by train.
Up there in lights, I'll be.
Go ask the Gershwins, a Kaufman and Lark, the place they love the best. The California pays me for their art. The fan mail comes addressed to NYC. Tomorrow a penthouse that's way up high.
Say to some popcorn. I haven't had popcorn since.
Give in. Don't fight. Good girl. Good night. Sleep tight. In NYC.
Romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Warbucks already fed up of Annie?
On the contrary. Miss Hannigan, this is to be signed and returned to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken of Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie? The daughter of a millionaire?
The daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for just a moment? Got any more wonderful news?
Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Hiya, sis. Long time no see.
Rooster?
Arr.
They finally let you out of prison? What waiting for this time?
Some old geezer said I swindled him out $1,100.
Why'd he say that?
Because the rooster swindled him out $1,100.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine, Lily St. Regis from...
Jersey City.
Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So, who was that blondie I bumped into coming here? Looked like she had a couple dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
Any one of the orphans from here is getting adopted by him.
Crummy orphan.
Yeah, living in the lap of luxury while the Hannigan kids ended up on the skids. It ain't fair how we scrounge for $3 or $4 while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts while we get peanuts. She's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, this little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give you one guess.
Yes! Easy Street. Easy Street. Annie is the key.
About it. Yes? Yes, we'll talk about it on...
Friday.
Friday! Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet? And you come over for Christmas with Mrs. Roosevelt for supper. Christmas Eve. You will. Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
Package from Tiffany's.
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her that I want to adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Have her come down here.
Yes, sir. Annie! Annie!
Hello.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. Someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a very good idea.
But I've lately realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have no one to share it with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broke. I was at Tiffany's yesterday and picked this up for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Oh, gee.
It's a silver locket. I noticed that old broken one you always wear. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket. Here, we'll just take that old one off.
No! I don't want a new locket.
Annie, what is it?
This locket? My mother and father left it when they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too, saying that they loved me, that they were coming back for me. I know I'm real lucky being here with you for Christmas, Mr. Warbucks, but the one thing I want in all the world is to find my mother and father and to be like other kids with folks of my own.
It'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your parents for you.
Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father if he has to put everybody in his organization on the job. If he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket. I understand, but this could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI trace it and find out who bought it.
Then maybe they should have my note, too.
You watch, Annie. You might be meeting your mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
What a thing to occur, finding them, losing her. Oh, you won't be an orphan for long.
And pretty soon everyone will know that I'm looking for my mother and father, because we're going to go on the radio and tell them. So make sure you listen, okay? So maybe now it's time.
Thank you, Annie. And welcome to America's favorite radio program, The Occident, Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Burke Healy. Good evening, Olive Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Burke Healy. It's nice to be here.
Olive Warbucks, I understand you have something to tell folks back home about little Annie here.
Yes, Bert Healy, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I am offering a certified check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
Wow!
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Occident. This is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station, good night.
Had a little baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl, our Annie.
You're Annie's parents? I can't believe it. Where'd you say you come from again?
A little farm up in Canada where we have lots of geese and chickens and ducks and roosters! Arr, 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 arr! I gotcha, sis.
Rooster? I never would have known it was you in 100 years!
Fooled you, Aggie, and we're gonna fool Warbucks too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
But we need your help, sis, for details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half.
Half?
Half.
Okay, 25 grand each, but we gotta do it fast. Get the money, get the kid, and get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What would we do with her afterward?
No problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears. For good. We get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy town, and then we'll meet ya.
Where? Oh, yeah.
Well, Miss Farrell?
I'm sorry, Annie. I've spoken to more than 1,000 people claiming to be your mother and father. They were all liars and fakes.
Aw, gee!
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Warbucks, this is a special delivery from the FBI.
Ah, finally! Agent Gundersated located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold. Annie, I'm afraid the FBI doesn't think that there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents through the locket. I'm so sorry.
That's okay, Mr. Warbucks. You did your best. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along fine without parents. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace.
Yes, sir.
Do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
Mr. Warbucks, if I can't have my own folks, there's nobody in the world I'd rather have than you.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration, and you can have anyone in the world you want to come to it. Who would you like?
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell, and Drake here, and Mrs. Pugh, and, well, everybody here.
Drake!
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it'll be way past their bedtime now. But I'll tell you what, we'll have everyone from the orphanage tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last, together forever. We're tied a knot, they never can sever.
I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue.
I don't need anything but you.
Yesterday was plain awful.
You could say that again.
Yesterday was plain awful.
divide us.
But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple seller too,
I don't eat anything.
Anything.
Anything. I don't eat anything but you.
Excuse us, folks. Shirley, look, there's our Annie.
Who are you?
Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Mudge is the name, Rolf Mudge, and this here is my wife, Shirley.
And you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
We've spoken to many people.
I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here is Annie's birth certificate and my driver's license.
Baby girl, name, Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Rolf and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th? And that's my birthday.
Rolf, look, Annie's wearing our locket.
When we left Annie behind 11 years ago, we left half of a silver locket and kept the other half. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, God, Rolf, she's our Annie.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but I'll be willing to give you whatever.
You haven't heard that I'm offering a certified check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
No, sir, but anyway, we don't want any money.
On the other hand, Rolf, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey with $50,000. We could afford to bring Annie up right in the country.
Would you mind if Annie stayed here until tomorrow, Christmas? Then you could come pick her up and the check.
Sure, whatever you'd like.
Bye, Annie, love.
Bye, Annie. When we come back, you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Oops, pardon me, Blondie, and Merry Christmas.
Well, this is...
wonderful news.
Drake, champagne. We must celebrate because this is just the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father. I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge.
No! Annie!
I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that I've seen that Rolf Mudge before.
He's not who he says he is.
Then I won't give up until we're certain.
But how?
I'll find a way. I'll go straight to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat! FBI men coming and going, and Annie, Did you know that President Roosevelt is here?
Really?
Mr. President?
Merry Christmas, Mr. President.
Merry Christmas, Annie. Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. He succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
But
you... Annie.
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean I'm an orphan after all?
Oh, you're right, Annie.
Yes, I'm fine. Because I know that they loved me and that they would have come for me.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
I love you, Mr. Warbucks. But wait! Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could easily have been forged. But only us knew about the locket.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan!
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Annie!
There's presents for Ollie about
this!
Ah, Miss Hannigan! I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here, and I'd know you anywhere.
Let me introduce you to everyone. You know my secretary, Miss Farrell, and this is the President of the United States. And of course, my butler, Drake.
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Now it all fits together.
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
We wouldn't like to bother you on Christmas and all. We just came here to pick up the check. And Annie.
Ah, yes. The check. Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000. Certified.
Certified. Paid to the order of... The jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dead.
Rooster, Lewis, turn him over.
Yes, sir.
Ah, and I believe that this woman is their accomplice.
I've never seen these people till yesterday.
Come off it, Aggie.
Annie, tell him how nice and good I always was to you.
I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan. I would. But remember the one thing you always taught me. Never tell a lie!
Brat!
Miss Hannigan's gone for good!
Hooray!
And you won't have to work anymore.
Hooray!
Yes, girls. For you and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. A new deal. I like that. A new deal.
So do I, Franklin. A new deal.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun.
Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow.